What's going on, boxing fans? Julian Williams here at the distance. Got a video for you guys this afternoon. This is the post-fight video to Matthew Macklin versus Felix Sturm. Fight was for the WBA middleweight championship. The fight was very spectacular. I'm joking. I'm actually making fun of Roy Jones from last week when he called the Saul Alvarez spectacular. Love Roy Jones, but damn, it is what it is. Overall, this was a very close fight. You had a lot of, I think it was full of swing rounds to where it could have possibly gone either way. But first off, I'll say this. I thought that Macklin won the fight. What you had in this fight was you had effective aggression versus clean, effective punches. So you have two types of effectiveness against each other. So what won for me was effective aggression. Effective aggression for me because the effective aggression was what led to the clean, effective punches. Very few times in the fight did you see Felix Sturm take the lead compared to Matthew Macklin. Matthew Macklin was throwing all the punches. He was the one coming forward. And if you look at it, he was taking a lot of... he was taking the signature punches away from Felix Sturm. He didn't give him much room in this fight either. If you look closely at this fight and look at Felix Sturm's style, Felix Sturm loves to throw that left uppercut, going back. And he couldn't throw it because he didn't have enough room. Also, to a certain essence, Matthew Macklin kind of took that left uppercut away. The way that he took the uppercut away was, if you observe closely at the fight, every time Felix Sturm went back, Macklin pretty much positioned his gloves to where he didn't get the full punch. He didn't get the full punch. So like he would kind of position his gloves or position his arms to where he didn't catch that punch cleanly. Also the left hook was not too, I don't think it was too effective in the fight. Looking at the fight, I don't think the left hook was too effective due to the fact that looking closely at it, Macklin had tucked his chin and tucked his shoulders to where he didn't get all the power from behind the punch. Sturm really didn't get a chance to sit down on his punches all that much because Macklin kept coming forward and he was smothering him and taking all kinds of room away from him to where he couldn't effectively get his punches off and sit down on him, which was a smart thing to do. It was continuous pressure, aggression was effective, and it led to opportunities for both fighters. Really, if you ask me, Matthew Macklin continued to come back from punches that Sturm threw. So getting into the full breakdown of the fight, the first three rounds I did give to Macklin. I gave the first three rounds to Macklin just based off the fast pace that he was fighting at. The whole entire fight he was fighting at a fast pace. But in these first three rounds, he pretty much was setting the tone of the fight. He was coming forward. He started to throw hooks inside and pretty much outlanded him. Outthrew him and just continued to come forward. And Sturm did land a clean counter right hook and a clean uppercut in those rounds, but those are the only things that that I could tell you I remember seeing. Rounds 4, 5, and 6, I gave to Felix Sturm. Felix Sturm started to use Macklin's aggression against him. He started to come back. He started hitting him with the counter right hook a little more. He hit him with the left hook a little more. He go for the uppercut to the body. He was more effective, and he's pretty much more effective in these rounds, 4, 5, and 6. So halfway through the fight, I had a 3-3. Round 7, I gave to Macklin. I gave round 7 to Macklin because Macklin fought at a fast pace again. He fought at a fast pace, so I gave that one to Macklin. I gave round 8 to Sturm. pretty much based on clean effect of punching again. But also that's around, I could say, is a swing round, round eight. But I did give that one to Sturm. I gave round 10 to Macklin. I gave those rounds to Macklin, based on his aggression in the fight. So I gave round 9 and 10 to Macklin. He was coming forward. He was cutting off the angles, cutting off the ring. And throwing more, though, you can argue whether or not Sturm won those rounds. So overall, coming into this part of the bout, I only have Sturm winning 3 rounds. And I gave him round 11. I gave him round 12. So I have it 7-5 for Felix Sturm. For Matthew Macklin. Though I might have to watch again because I watched the fight twice already. The first time I scored it, I had it a draw. The second time I watched it, I had 7-5 Macklin. Third time, I had 7-5 Macklin again. So I might have to watch it again to get... to get more clarification of the rounds, to be honest with you. But overall, that's just what I saw. That's what I observed. So check me out on Ustream tonight. The name is Julian Foster, 88, the distance after hours. We'll be following the Devin Alexander-Lucas Matisse fight. And I'll get into more comprehensive coverage of the bouts. So up next, Love Moendo versus Kell Brook, the one-sided beating. I'm gonna watch that bout again, and I'm gonna get back to you guys. So anyway, guys, you guys have a great night. That was Distance. Thanks for watching. Peace. Man, why the fuck is my iPhone not working?